just want to take this time to reiterate one of the things that I see that occurs in today's modern churches. The Bible talks about how Simon believed also in the book of Acts chapter 8 when he was seeing and beholding all the miracles that Philip was doing. And the Bible says that when Peter and John was called down from Jerusalem to come and see the work that was going on in Samaria, the Bible lets us know that when Simon saw that through the laying on of hands, the Holy Spirit was given, he offered Peter and John money. And when they saw that, they told him, boy, you are in the bowl of the gall of bitterness. Notice what he says. And we want to look at this again because I want you to understand what's going on here. The Bible says in verse number 20, Peter said to him, your money perish with you because you thought that the gift of God could be purchased with money. You have neither part nor portion in this matter, and your heart is not right in the sight of God. Verse number 22 says, repent therefore of this your wickedness and pray if perhaps the thought of your heart may be forgiven you. So notice here, the Bible lets us know that this man, he believed and was baptized according to the scripture. And the Bible lets us know, but he still hadn't repented. He still hadn't turned from his greed. He still didn't turn from his ways that were bitter towards God. He hadn't turned away from the sin, just like a lot of people today. And I can remember when I was first saved, when I was in college and I was saved, received the Lord Jesus Christ into my life, like people say, I had done just that. But there was something wrong because I still was continuing to live and cohabitate with my girlfriend at the time. No, you know, we were doing what we were supposed to do. The Bible lets us know that, you know, sexual sin is a sin. And so as a result, I was saved, wanted to get the baptism of the Holy Spirit, was going to church and doing all of the things, but I was still living with my girlfriend at the time and sleeping with her and having sexual relationships with her. So therefore, I hadn't really repented. And then later on in my life, as I progressed in God, you know, those same sins from way back then when I did not let go, when I was first born again, guess what happened? It came and crept up again. Why? Because I never dealt with them. I never repented of them. I never told God that I was sorry for them. You know, I made excuses for them, you know, like we do today. And as a result, it cost me. So I'm just trying to save you, my friend, a long trip from being disappointed. Because let me tell you something. The time to find out that you did not have the goods is not when you stand before the Lord Jesus Christ as your judge. But the time to find out is now while you're in this life and getting the truth that will make you free. Now, let's go on from there. The scripture lets us know, and let's look at verse number 29 of the same chapter, Acts chapter 8, verse number 29. The Bible lets us know in verse number number 26. Now an angel of the Lord spake to Philip, saying, arise and go towards the south along the road which goes down from Jerusalem to Gaza. This is desert. And so he arose and went, and behold, a man of Ethiopia, a eunuch of great authority under Candace, the queen of the Ethiopians, who had charge of all her treasury and had come to Jerusalem to worship, was returning and sitting in his chariot. He was reading Isaiah the prophet. Then the Spirit said to Philip, go near and overtake this chariot. So Philip ran to him and heard him reading the prophet Isaiah and said, do you understand what you are reading? And he said, how can I unless someone guides me? And he asked Philip to come up and sit with him. The place in the scripture which he read was this. He was led as a sheep to the slaughter, and like a lamb silent before shearers, so he opened not his mouth. And his humiliation, his justice was taken away. And who would declare his generation? His life was taken from the earth. So the eunuch answered Philip and said, I ask you, of what does this prophet say of this? Of himself or some other man? Then Philip opened his mouth and beginning at the scripture, preached Jesus to him. Now as they went down the road, they came to some water, and the eunuch said, here, see, here is water. What hinders me from being baptized? Then Philip said, if you believe with all your heart, you may. And he answered and said, I believe that Jesus is the Son of God. So he commanded the chariot to stand still, and both Philip and the eunuch went down into the water, and he baptized him. And when they came out of the water, the Spirit of the Lord caught away Philip, so that the eunuch saw him no more, and he went on his way rejoicing. Notice this. The Bible says, what hinders me to be baptized. He says, if you believe with all your heart. Someone say, well, I don't see nothing about repentance right here. Back up, and the Bible lets you know. And verse number 27, this man had come to Jerusalem to what? To worship. So he knew God, but he just didn't know about the Lord Jesus Christ, whom God sent. So here it is. We see that this man also was baptized. He said, I believe. I believe Jesus is the Son of God. So now let's go to the ninth chapter of the book of Acts, and we're going to discover something here about Saul's conversion. The Bible says in verse number 17, and Ananias went his way and entered the house, and laying his hands on him, talking about Saul, he said, Brother Saul, the Lord Jesus, who appeared to you on the road as you came, has sent me that you might receive your sight and be filled with the Holy Ghost. Immediately there fell from his eyes something like scales, and he received his sight, and at once he arose and was baptized. Notice, at once he arose and was what? Baptized. Now, we're following the New Testament pattern. Someone might say, he ain't saying nothing about repentance right here. Okay, hold your horses. We're going to get to it in just a minute. In the 22nd chapter of Acts, Paul giving his own personal testimony. Luke was writing about that experience, but here Paul gives his own testimony. Notice what he says in verse number 6. Now it happened as I journeyed and came near Damascus about noon, suddenly a great light from heaven shone about me. And I fell to the ground and heard a voice saying to me, Saul, Saul, why are you persecuting me? So I answered, who are you, Lord? And he said to me, I am Jesus of Nazareth, whom you are persecuting. Now those who were with me indeed saw the light and were afraid, but they did not hear the voice of him who spoke to me. So I said, what shall I do, Lord? And the Lord said to me, arise and go into Damascus, and there you will be told all the things which are appointed for you to do. And since I could not see for the glory of that light, being led by the hand of those who were with me, I came to Damascus. And one, Ananias, a devout man according to the law, having a good testimony with all the Jews who dwelt there, came to me and stood and said to me, Brother Saul, receive your sight. And at that same hour, I looked up at him. Then he said, the God of our fathers has chosen you that you should know his will and see the just one and hear the voice of his mouth. For you will be his witness and to all men of what you have seen and heard. And now, why are you waiting? Arise and be baptized and wash away your sins, calling on the name of the Lord. See, there's something to this baptism after all, isn't it? That's right. He says, repent, rise, repent, calling on the name of the Lord. Notice what he said. Oh, my goodness. Why are you waiting? Arise, be baptized, wash away your sins, calling on the name of the Lord. So what was he doing? He was repenting. He was calling on the name of the Lord, trusting him and him alone for his salvation. There it is, my friend. Everyone's following the New Testament pattern, the New Testament foundation, the New Testament plan that God placed in his word. And that plan, my friend, is salvation and baptism, but first of all,